Man, I better get a government pension for this shit.
Yeah, who did?
Oh, hello. This is Raul from the cab company. They said you bought the business, so I wanted to introduce myself.
All right, cool. Shit. Good to meet you.
It's a solid business. We do well. Some of our regulars can be a little fussy, but what do you expect in LS, right? I'll give you a call if anything comes up, okay?
All right, sounds good.
Yo, yo, one time for your mind. Salute, nigga. Now this bad kid, a.k.a. Quasimodo, a.k.a. yesterday's new Quintet, all up on Stone Store, packing all that. Checking out Josh Peterson, worldwide, you know what I mean? 2000 beyond.
That's dumb luck right there.
Got off lucky, homie.
shit!
I can't come to the phone right now.
This is Dr. Isaiah Friedlander's office. There's no one here right now. Leave a message and we'll book you in as soon as we can. Be well.
Sunset with girls he picked up the night before. We're very nautical here on Los Santos Rock Radio. We're about girls and fishing and sunsets.
Weasel News.
Industrial espionage in Lane County as thieves steal perfume formula.
The candidates for governor are sneaking shit.
Movie stars are up in arms. No, not over some liberal nonsense. Over more sense. Some highly trained thieves raid a couple research lab. In order to steal perfume, several men were killed as raiders carried out an audacious attack that has confused the lab's owners and criminal investigators as the robbers escaped.
Hello.
Hello. Thank God you stopped. Were you a fan of Frank Mathers?
Frank Mathers? The TV guy who used to do the shows about space until he became obsessed with undersea exploration? No, not a huge fan.
Frank was my husband.
By not a huge fan, I mean, not a huge fan as much as a fanatic.
He was a cruel and heartless man.
Well, like I said, I was not a huge fan.
But I loved him.
Didn't he leave his sick wife and five kids to run off with you?
We loved each other.
I'm sure he did.
And I'm penniless now, more or less. Well, Frank's submarine broke apart while he was trying to save the San Andreas White Shark. But his body was never found.
You know, people thought someone tampered with the airlocks.
That's an outright lie. That was never proven. I love Frank, and Frank loved me, which is why we invested so much money in life insurance. If we could just prove that Frank was dead and that the airlocks weren't tampered with, I would sleep so much easier.
I bet you would.
I'll make it very worth your while.
Guess I could take a look.
Thank you. volcano eruption. What is in 84 corner people?
What is the number? I didn't answer. What is the number?
Hello?
So, I think I got the pieces from Frank's son.
You did? That's wonderful news. Can you meet me back on the pier at Polito Cove?
I can't, but the thing is, well, I'll tell you in person.
Hey, where'd you get that antique plaid shirt? None of your business. Where'd you get that hand-pressed tofu? At a shop called None of Your Business. What?
Thank you. strong, I know this feeling good and strong. Trying hours, you seem to get alone. I want to test the fact you mean so much to me.
I'm a bundle of nerves.
Hey, I found it. Well, here's the good stuff.
Oh, you precious, precious man.
Yeah, but I gotta tell you, I think the airlocks were tampered with.
No, that's just normal wear and tear. It may surprise you to learn that along with being a beautiful, finely put together woman, I am also an expert in nautical engineering and glass degradation.
Yeah, but I mean, look, it's... Oh. Looks like Frank tried to scratch a message in with his last dying breath. It says, someone tampered with the airlocks.
How can that be? My poor Frank. It must have been his ex-wife, very bitter woman.
Yeah, well, I don't know anything about that. I'm not a detective, you know, but something doesn't ring true here.
No, I know. The police are in on it. I'm going to take this to the FIB. They'll know what to do.
Yeah, well, that's your business. Hey, ho, whoa! Said you're gonna make it worth my while.
Yes. This should be plenty for your time and discretion.
It's $10. Oh.
Here's a signed photo of Frank. He was a lovely person. You would have been great friends. He loved his fans. I've gotta get going to the FIB, I mean.
You gotta be fucking kidding me.
Ah!
please.
Vinewood Boulevard Radio. And if you think we're talking about the part with the idiot tourist and the stars on the ground that people pay for to be walked on till the end of time, you're wrong. It's the better, more real part down the street.
Gotcha!
Where the comic book shop is.
Here you go.
Oh, you are such a sweetheart. I'm not even from here. Thanks so much.
We'll be right back.
Santos Underground Radio presents 25-8 with Solomon.
Hello, Los Santos. This is Solomon. So welcome to my residency.
You seem mellow.
Enjoy your ignorance, pal, right up to the point where the government's rogering you senseless while pissing on your kid's future.
Thank you.
again.
Hey, look! We have a fucking pendejo walking up there!
You sick fuck!
I can mess you up real good, you know?
Disgusting!
Whatever. I'm gonna seriously fuck you up, man!
Do we have a problem?
Okay, it's cool. I apologize.
All right, let's get this bad boy in the van, huh?
Yeah, I'm starving. Let's get this over with.
Yeah.
our stuff.
Boom!
Intergalactic.
Yes!
You should have heard me coming.
Of the 70s and 80s are still doing today.
Rednecks. Hello. Yeah, can you send out a cab to me?
Of course. Driver should be with you soon.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
look like shit. Oh, great!
Where you headed, homie?
Raton can't. Alright, brother, here we are.
Hey!
Alright, let's go!
They are making in their own lives. And one decision we all gotta make is to stop.
Anybody out there good for pickup?
Our economy. I mean, it just ain't right. You cannot get a job right now because foreigners have them. Well, America did not become the greatest country in the world. Foreigners in, and that's a fact. Listen, Bobby June. Listen, all of you. I am not a racist. I said some things, yeah, I did. That was a very long time ago. If we want this country to be great again, we've got to start fighting wars we can win and stop fighting against crazy folk who ain't gonna give up. Which is why I want us to think about invading Europe again. Seriously.
How do you mean?
Now, I ain't never been one for book learning, but I'm a big fan of history documentaries. And historical television shows us that America is at its finest when we invade Europe.
You know something? You're right!
Exactly. I mean, we've spent 50 years invading Asia and the Middle East, and it ain't right. Them folks don't want us. They're too different. Patronizing
cheese. You pick up. Who wants it? First come, first serve.
I promise you, if Great Britain wants to stand in our way, I'll tell you what, we'll invade them too. Make them start speaking English and everything. Now, I've seen a lot of movies, and how often is the world threatened by a creepy British guy? It's never an American. Not never. So I'm saying, if we're serious about fighting terror, and I know we are, we go straight to the source and invade Great Britain. Finish off what old George started back in 1770, whenever it was.
USA! USA! USA!
That's how we're gonna win this war, Bobby June. That's how we're gonna finish the American lives, by killing every goddamn one of them bastards, pardon my French, because that's what love is all about.
Hey, they love you, George. You got my vote.
Bobby June, let's talk about this election. It's really up to everybody to get out there and make a difference. You gotta do everything in your power to make sure we win. This is not a socialist country, it's not. This is America.
I'd like to order a cab, please.
On its way, sir. Thanks for calling.
Great.
Our society is our nation. But trust me, this is the most important moment in American history. If we get this wrong, well, we're shit out of luck. Pardon my French.
How so?
Who's that?
Not Producer Ricky. Speaking out of turn again. Don't worry. She's just got a tan.
Oh, okay. Had me
worried. I need a driver for a pickup right away.
Because this is it. They are trying to steal our country away. Lawton and all his cronies. Whatever. What do you think about affirmative action? Hey, you ain't a Lebanon, is you? I mean, ain't nothing wrong with it. Some of my best friends was Lebanons, but it's unnatural and a sin. So affirmative action is gone. Having to hire foreigners is gone. Making schools accept minorities is gone. Subsidizing education is gone.
Yeah, hey, I need a cab.
I'm sending one out right now.
Thank you.
It's real change. Change we want. Change back. Because I'm all about families, and families need children at home.
Jock, I have to say, I loved your reality show when you were a police officer arresting people. I'm pretty sure it was home. Hit him with that nightstick. You're real serious about crime. You beat the tar out of him.
These people ask for hope. I give them handcuffs. They need a fight.
Chase minorities with a police helicopter isn't great night of family TV is what it is. You're speaking lots of sense, Chalk, but all this politics has got me hungry. I reckon we should make some dessert together. What you think?
Well, I just love that.
All righty. Let's see what
call just came in. Who wants to do a pickup right now?
Peanut butter, graham crackers, red hots, non-dairy topping, sprinkles.
You've reached Abigail Mathers. Please leave a message if you have any information relating to Frank's death rather than going to the police.
All right, we're gonna throw them all together. Quick whisk.
I love this already. What are...
Can you get a cab here as soon as possible?
Stay where you are. I got a driver right around the corner.
Sounds good, thanks.
For a job.
We are by far the best radio station in Los Santos. Yo soy Don Cheto.
Y yo soy el Mexican Institute.
Excuse me. I'm sorry about it.
Thank you.
Yeah, I need a cab as soon as you can.
No problem. I'll have one there in a couple of minutes.
Thanks.
Okay, buddy, there you go.
Ah, it's insured. Don't be a dick.
Fucking hell.
Is this or get ravaged by a burly Russian with the St. Petersburg surprise? Rectify Holistic. Come and get properly cleaned today.
Anybody out there good for pickup?
Shouldn't have called.
Patricia! Mrs. Madrazo! Hey!
Are you behaving, Trevor?
Yeah, sure. Patricia, I really miss you. The time together. Very important.
I have to go.
We'll be going away. I love you so especially.
I miss you already! What the F-word are you doing here?
That's a funny way to greet your cousin.
You ain't my G-damn cousin, Trevor.
I thought we was family.
But please, just go and ruin somebody else's home furnishings.
Who the F is that, boy?
No one, my sweet!
Hey, by any chance, did you catch crabs at that conference? I heard that those conferences are regular little fuckfest, huh? Guy, come in.
I'd like you to leave right now.
Oh, yeah. Some serious corporate gangbanging going on, right? Yeah, with every executive and director of communications from here to Bangalore taking it left, right, and center in the name of team training, right? I mean, now that's what Floyd told me yesterday as he was staring at my, my penis.
I want you to leave now!
Look, this is all I've got, all right? I had a tough upbringing. My daddy was not nice to me, okay? Now look, Deborah, I love you, and I love you too, Floyd. Why can't we all just be together, huh? You can have Mondays through Thursdays. You can have the weekends, all right? I know that's not normal, but in this crazy, crazy world, is normal so good, huh? Look, Deborah, Floyd, will you marry me?
Get out of my condo! And you go too, Floyd! I told you, I've got a career! I don't need this crap!
Yes!
There. You made me swear. You're crap, Floyd. Crap! You're not a man at all. Bob's right about you.
Oh, who's Bob?
I want both of you to go now, you and your weird friend.
Whoa! Hey! My name is Trevor, sweetheart.
I could give a fuck what your fucking name is! I'm not afraid to use this. I'm not. Bob taught me.
Fuck Bob! You people are not very fucking nice!
Oh, hey there, Trevor.
Oh. Hey there, Wade.
Did you meet Gebra?
Interesting lady.
I should probably go say hi.
I wouldn't.
Why not?
Let's go get in the car, all right? Let's go have the time of our lives. Oh, I know exactly where to take you.
I could run in and get Floyd and Gebra. I know she seems kind of uptight, but she can have fun.
No. I don't think she can, Wade.
Just Floyd then?
Floyd's gonna meet us there.
Floyd's trip!
Exactly.
Oh, Trevor, man, you got all over yourself. You're all red. You got syrup?
Yeah! Syrup. Accident. We've all been there.
We sure have, but... But it don't taste like syrup.
Don't taste me, all right? No licking.
Okay.
Hey, you remember... Oh, what the fuck is wrong with you? You remember when we met?
Sure. Last year. I was on the way to the gathering with Daisy Bell and Kush Chronic and...
And you stopped in Sandy Shores to get lit, and you met a dealer, and he looked after you when your friends abandoned you.
That was weird, weren't it? The last time I saw him, it was with you, driving out to the quarry, and then they just disappeared.
Poof, right? I mean, they were gone. Some friends, right? And now Cousin Gebra don't want you around them. There's a pattern here.
The Congo did get messy.
Look, this is it.
So, this is where Floyd is gonna meet us, a strip club?
Oh, yeah.
That's unlike him. He's a real homebody. He loves that apartment.
Interestingly, you and me, we got a new home.
Where?
Here. Right here.
Here?
Here. Now, I know it's unconventional, but that's the way we roll, homie. Hey, you two. You two, I want you to give this boy a good time. For a long time. Hey, gorgeous, gorgeous, gorgeous. Tell me where the manager is for this fine establishment.
Through there and take two doors to the right.
Through there.
To the right.
Thank you. Amigo! Prepare to meet your new partner.
Hey, Lester.
Hey, Trevor just called about the big one, the UD. You know anything?
Yeah, I told him we could hit it. You down?
Of course I'm down. Look, I'll get my research together and meet you at Trevor's. He's taking over the Vanilla Unicorn Gentlemen's Club.
All right, message Franklin.